Whoa! Whoa! I thought you was already gone!
Tell her I never stop.
Thank you.
easy. Got a trail. Got a good head start on me. Must be a way off. Must be close. gotta go, boy. Yep. Second thoughts, stay right there. Yeah. Move! All that hard work and nothing but scraps out there, huh?
Been a while since you were through here. Remember you. Passed through here some time ago, huh?
Okay, fella.
Yeah. blood I don't know about here?
Relax, my friend. Never mind.
All right, bye. Glad to see you again, sir. So, buying or selling?
This spoke saddle delivered right to your stable.
Isn't that the meanest looking coyote you ever saw? You've done the folk of Scarlet Meadows a favor by the looks of it. All right, let's have a look. Boy, the things I can make with this.
And boots made here, folks.
Come on.
Hello again. That was quick. Okay, let's take a look at it.
I hope you make good use of that.
My garments is a little different.
Thanks.
Close enough.
Last chance to buy or sell.
Thank you.
Isn't that the meanest looking coyote you ever saw? You've done the folk of Scarlet Meadows a favor by the looks of it.
So, I got, 11 pound just for the carcass and then 22 pound for the pelt, which that's an extra 11 pound for the carcass rather than selling it all together for 22 pound. You know, I didn't realize I've dropped it actually, so that was good. yeah, so we're gonna set up camp.
Welcome back, sir.
Yeah, hold on. Alright, let me open my map. So yeah, we're gonna go to there. Then, this is interesting, the veteran's home. So we might pop there. I think we're just gonna leave that Joe Maston thing for a minute. I think we might explore just up here a little bit. So yeah, I'm just gonna set up camp first though. Because I actually can't see very well. Oh, I'm running into a tree.
He's easy. Settle down, boy.
Beautiful sky. Ah, look at that. Let's set up my camp here. Oh, I've still got a tent. Oh, cool.
Nice fire. Mind if I warm my bones?
What the f...
Y'all knew this was Murphy Hills. You should be careful where you're camping.
I can look after myself. Besides, it's a free country.
Free country? No. Everything bought and paid for. And we gonna protect what's ours. Y'all be careful where you wander. Come on, let's go. I think you got the message.
Go kill you next time.
Oh shit. Jesus. Alright, let's camp. I was gonna freaking... Nope. They just ran off on their bikes. I could've killed them then. Bikes. On their thing. Horse ointment. What does that do? Crash the lap. I'm gonna do just improved. It's only flight feathers, so you kill a lot of birds and you get tons of flight feathers, as well as other feathers to craft improved arrows. I don't have a pistol. I got a repeater. That's what I want. I'm just gonna do that. I'm gonna go see what's going on with them people. Like, what the hell was that? They look like right here, but did you see his frown? He had a really big frown. They were wearing proper hillbilly clothes and were talking like hillbillies, maybe incestuous or inbreds. Obviously that used to be really popular, well, not popular, but really common back in the Old West. You know, incest between families and inbreeding. So, I think we're entering kind of the swampy areas now. Especially with the fact that there's bait shops and things around here. Split point rifle cartridges. Split point is better to have. So, it may take some time, but it's better just to do it. Revolver, that's what, that's what I'm doing. Okay, let's go to sleep till morning. 3 hours. Compendium updated. The Murphy Brood. The Murphy Brood are blue to have immigrated to America in the 1700s, where they live comfortably. The industrialization of the area drove the family to live in a secluded life in the hills. Now the family resides in a cave in Beaver Hollow, only venturing out to the surrounding areas for hunting and scavenging. Can be found roaming around Beaver Hollow. So we discovered an additional gang. So obviously there's obviously quite a few gangs. There's that one, that's one, two, three, four, five, six gangs altogether. So we know the Driscolls. We've had 33% progress with them. Gang camps found, we found two. Ambushes survived one. Unique encounters three. Gang members killed 70. Hideouts found one. Okay, and now obviously these, 33%. Unique encounters one. Ambushes survived one. Don't remember surviving an ambush, maybe that was just the one then. No, never killed any of them, so yeah. That's a bit weird. So let me open my journal real quick, because maybe something's added in that. So we've got the legendary coyote. Show gang savings. Encrypted, I can't really read it. Anyway, let's. The Murphy Rude, yeah, we just did that, love. Alright, I'm gonna tear down the camp. I'm gonna leave your tent open. Because if you leave the tent, then it'll respawn when you pick the camp back up. So, now we know of a new gang!
Yep.
In this area. Don't know where Beaver Hollow is. But still, we're gonna pop to that camp. And then to the veterans' home. And then that, you know, we'll just see what happens.
Hey, boy.
Hell, if there's a quest at that camp, then we'll probably just go to that camp. Sorry, horse. My fault entirely. Alright, we'll leave you there to recover your health. Oh, did put it on the ground. Always try and pick up cigarettes. 32 Martha from Garfield, August 17th, 1864. My dearest Martha, I miss you so much. Life makes sense when we are together. This war no longer makes sense to me. When I signed up, oh, it seemed like a thousand lifetimes ago. Everything seems so simple. We're going to express our rights as states to do as we goddamn well pleased and hang whatever any fools in the North told us. I can't believe now that this was a principle I would die for, and yet is a principle I've seen so many men I grew up with be slaughtered for. That and their own stupid pride. We Southerners are such proud fools. Now I am only proud about one thing. The love I share with you. You, a Yankee. An abolitionist. Don't know. Everything I was supposed to hate and now love so dear. How can you love me back when I'm such a fool? Da 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 da. Cowardice. None of you trust him. Da da da. Right, whatever. Bit boring to read that, to be honest. So the owner of this cabin has been dead for a little while. Jewelry. Nightstand, candy, search cabinet, ground coffee, search drawer, rifle cartridges. So they were in love and she died there. We don't know how she died, but she died. Oh, poor sod. Right, where are we going next? Martha Swain. I don't get, like, what, is there something special? To me, she's just dead on the floor. She's literally must have died years ago. Yeah, she literally must have died just like years ago. Porta potty, that's ripped to shreds. Who's been going in there? wrong way. I need to go towards this creek. Oh, let's turn around. This creek then.
Good morning.
I thought I pulled my gun out and then I did after I said it. I tried to put it away.
Something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Where do you need to go?
You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
You're freaking kidding me. Is she kidding? I'm not being... Oh my god.
We ain't hardly going nowhere at this speed. Glad I ran into you.
Alright, well, we'll just gonna go there. We'll deliver this woman back.
Raised it since it was just a foal.
Losing a horse is hard. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that horse did right by me. Better than my husband, truth be told. That fool, always complaining. But does he do something about it? Man barely lifts his hand to wave the flies away. Aside from to lift a drink, of course. Marriage, for me, has been nothing but trouble. But Biscuit, he was a fine animal. Loyal, smart, brave. Didn't take no guff, not from no one. Had one of them mountain boys pull a gun on me once. I was riding up near the Dakota and had stopped by a nice warm patch. Must have dozed off, but I wake up and find some nasty piece of work pointing a rusty shotgun straight at me. Well, he gets wheezing on and I must have made some sort of noise. Because the next thing I know, Biscuit had nipped his ear clean off. Kicked his hide, too, as he was hollering away. Didn't think a man could run so fast.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, had a good laugh on that one. I tell the husband, what does he do? Should have never gone over there, honey, he says. Gee, thanks.
So, you live at Emerald Ranch, then?
For the time being, I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. I'll be moving on soon, though. Emerald Ranch, well, it's a strange place.
How so?
The owner's a mean bastard. Strange, too. Delights in bullying folk. There's a daughter, but she never leaves the house. You can see her in the window sometimes. When I asked about her, everybody told me to leave it alone. Found an old saloon there, all shut down now, but I went in to have a look, and there's bullet holes, old blood stains. Something definitely happened there, but I couldn't figure it. Just an uncomfortable feeling to the place. Oh, we're getting close now. Here we go. This is great. This was kind of you, mister. Please, take this as my way of thanking you. Appreciate it. What a lousy day.
I think I broke that quest, to be honest, in this video, and then in the next episode, we will be stealing from a train, and probably then going up that way, back up the way we came.
Oh, you got something for me?
Oh, let's sell some stuff, though. Ooh, look at that.
Very nice. Shame to part with it, I bet.
Yeah, well, that was that. Okay. Thank you for watching. between us now, won't you?